Happy Mother's Day, everybody. Okay, so today I'm gonna show you somewhat of a simple Mother's Day breakfast that most of us should have somewhat of the similar ingredients at home. Okay, so I'm gonna start with crepes. So I actually put this mix together at 5 a.m. in between teaching times. So all it is, I'm gonna put the ingredients down below, but it's basically, you know, flour, water, butter, milk. I mean, it's not the most healthy thing, but it's Mother's Day, so have something fun. So what I have here is I have my two pans. Now these pans are more of a French style pan that actually my mother had gotten for me, I think, for a past Mother's Day. A lot of the really nice stuff she's found, so it's really wonderful. Okay, so basically I let this sit in the fridge for an hour. You don't need to do an hour, you could do 30 minutes. Just let it sit. If longer, it's okay. So if you want to prepare it the night before, it should be fine. I like to prepare it that morning ahead and just let it sit for 30 minutes to 1 hour. So what I do, and it's kind of my secret, is I put it in this jar, and all I do is I shake it up. One important thing, put the eggs on the bottom. That way the flour doesn't stick on the bottom. I did make that mistake before. Okay, so let's get started. One important thing with crepes is you really want to turn them all the way around. And one thing I did forget to get is these pans, because the material they're made out of do get a little hot. My hands can withstand some heat, but this one's a little bit too much. Okay, so you can pour it right in, or you could try to put a spoon in there. So it's really up to you. And what we're gonna do is we're just gonna pour it straight in there, and we're just gonna move it around. They're not gonna be perfect circles. It's okay. Okay, so then we're gonna do the next one. I have two going just to speed the process up. So I'm gonna show what it'll look like if you do too thick and too thin. So you'll see. One will be a little thinner, one will be a little thicker. So while those are cooking, I have them on medium high heat. Let's move to the next part of this. We have a melon. So this is a honeydew melon. What we're gonna do is we're gonna cut it straight in half. Depending on the size of your family, you might use the whole thing or just half. Just for us, I'm gonna go ahead and said, just toss that half there. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna scoop out the seeds. Now, if you tuned into the Campbell's Freedom Farm, one day she'll teach you how to grow these, I bet. So we'll just scoop them all out in case you get them all. Or if you don't want to grow them, you could always compost them. It's not a big deal either or. Okay, so basically we want to do slices like this. In a few seconds, we got to flip those. Okay, so we're going to make some nice, good slices for everybody. And what a refreshing morning to start off with some melon. And make sure you get a pretty good size knife. It's going to be hard to cut this if you have a small little puny knife. It's not going to work. Okay, the next thing, before we finish this up, we want to step back over. What I have is I have my knife here, not a serrated knife, just a butter knife. You don't need serious equipment. And you just kind of want to just flip it. And you can see if it sticks, it's not done. And sometimes these pans do stick a little bit. So you will have to butter in between each one. Okay, perfect. So now what we're gonna do, we're gonna take this. It's a little hot, but it's not too hot. It's warm enough that you could actually touch it. And we're gonna flip it over and let that side get more brown. Okay, let me come over to this side. And sometimes they do get stuck, like you can see. It also is this pan material, but I have found that this type of pan makes the best crepes compared to any other types of pans. You just have to make sure to put butter or olive oil for this. It's more of an unhealthy thing, but I actually prefer butter in this. It's the one thing I use butter instead of olive oil. Okay, so let's come back to this. What we wanna do, and this would be really cute, just cut nice slices in here. Not too small, but thick enough. And it's gonna look really pretty on the platter. Okay, so let's go to the next one. And you just wanna do this with all of them. Because you want to have a nice decoration. I know many people love to go out to eat on Mother's Day. You know what? What a better day just to cook at home. You know, if you don't cook much, this is something I think that you could definitely do. At least the melon, you could do this and have something else. Okay, so let's go ahead and slice this all up. And one thing that you can do with this, it's a little cold this morning, but depending on where you are, go outside and have a picnic. Get your blanket and go take your breakfast out and just have a really wonderful picnic outside with your family. And if not for breakfast, why not do it for lunch? All right, so what we do is we're gonna go ahead and take this. Let me check on these one more time. I'm gonna see how this is coming along. Just a few more seconds. And this one is actually done. So if you can see here, it's got just a nice tint of brown. You don't want it burnt, so we're gonna just flop that right there. And all you do is you just stack them on top of each other. Okay. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and take the next one. But we're gonna put on this one, since it was sticking just a tad, we're gonna put just a little bit more butter on it and really get it to go around. It doesn't take much butter. So just go ahead and, if you want, you can brush it around. If not, just pick the pan up and swirl it around. That's typically what I actually do. We're gonna take this, we're gonna pour a little bit in again, and we're gonna go ahead and just swirl this all the way around. And as you get better at this, you'll be able to make really nice circles. Okay, and this one should be pretty much done. See, look at this nice brown. And see, this one's thicker. So this is what this will look like if you put more batter in here. I like them thinner, but I wanted to show what the difference is. It's still gonna taste good, but it does taste significantly better. They're not meant to be pancakes. Okay, so pour the batter in. Okay, and then you just wanna swirl it all the way around. And I'll go ahead and try to link these pans below because they really are the best pans for crepes. And all right, let me go ahead and cook these two and I'll tune back in with you in a minute. All right, we're back. So we have a few more crepes here. Let me go ahead and put this one more on. And then I'm gonna show you what you can do with that melon. One thing I wanna say, sometimes, you know, people are really intimidated by crepes. And I never understood this because really, I actually find crepes much more simpler than pancakes. They're easier, they're thinner, and they're quite frankly a simple but delicious thing to make, and they're so versatile. They don't have to be used as a sweet bowl. They can be used for many different things. So don't be scared to try this. Just go ahead and give it a go and let me know how it works out. And one thing, I was talking to one of our pastors, one of our friends, and he actually, I mean, he speaks many languages, but he lived in France, and he was sharing with me that one day his teacher brought in a little stove thing and he actually cooked crepes right in front of him, and he said they were the best crepes he had ever had. So I had told him I'll have to make him and his family crepes one day so he can rehab that memory, because I think French crepes are one of my favorite. Okay, we're gonna let that cook and let me show you what we're gonna do next. So I have these, basically they just look really beautiful on the plate. And we have this really cute green platter and we're just basically gonna set them on there. And it just adds a little bit of style. You know, you have to style your food up. Okay, so we're gonna put this on. We'll mix up the shapes. So you kind of have a big one, and then you have a little one. Okay, so see, and then everybody just grabs them. All you do is you take them up, and you just bite right into it. It's brilliant just to have it this way. So we're gonna set these right here. And also, you can do thinner or a little thicker. So I gave both options. You know, if you're new to cutting, go for the thicker one. It's going to be a little less challenging. But if you really want this thinner and it's maybe a bigger family, try the thinner one. It'll be easier for that. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and flip this one. We don't want to neglect our crepes. Okay, so this one's done. See, look, they're just beautiful brown, thin. They're just perfect. Okay, so we're going to add just a little bit of butter to this one. I actually haven't added any to this pan yet. And I'm going to go ahead and link a few of these pans. So I've done a few tests where I've tried different types of pans. The other pans don't work. They just stick. They don't come out like crepes should. It does not work. So you really want this type of pan. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and tune back in. But before I do, I'm going to explain what we have here. Now, it took a lot of bribing for me to try lemon curd. I didn't get the whole thing. Why do you want lemon curd? And then my mother actually said, no, let's try it. So we got it from Trader Joe's. We can't get it right now, because we're trying not to go out. But it's the best lemon curd ever. One of these days, we're gonna have to do a show and make it together. It tastes amazing with these crepes. Another option is if you have heavy whipping cream, go ahead and put it in your blender, blend it up, and just go ahead and put it in a little bowl. You can scoop a little bit in there and have that. I think kids will like that even more than maybe the lemon curd, because some people don't like the sour. So those are your two options. All right, I'm gonna finish these up and I'll go ahead and see you soon. Hi, we're back. Okay, so we made all the crepes. You can see all these. And actually, They're quite warm. If you stack them on top together, you can see this one's pretty thin. Okay, so I actually went ahead and I whipped it up in our Nutribullet. I thought it was still on the countertop. just heavy whipping cream. I just wanted to show you. Actually, I think this is more Stefan's favorite, is the cream in the crepes. He prefers that. Okay, so I'm gonna bring you to the table. I'll see you there. All right, we're back. So you can see he's ready to put the cream in his crepes and show him what you do. You can roll them up like this. I'm gonna show you too. You can take them, you know, put whatever you want, and you can roll them like this, you know, a little more nicer. And you can just pick them up and just try them. And the lemon curd actually is one of my favorites. Good? Happy Mother's Day. Everybody, please subscribe and like this video.
Have a good one, Ben.
Bye.